All right, guys, we're back. In this video, we're going to talk about Google's Cybersecurity Professional Certificate. It's a relatively new certificate marketed towards people interested in getting into cybersecurity who have generally no experience. If you have interest in getting into cybersecurity, breaking in, this is definitely a certificate that I would recommend. I have not taken it myself. I do plan on doing so. Towards the end of the video, I'm going to explain why someone who's been in cyber for approximately 15 years would take this certificate. I have not taken it. I'm going to do that. And as I do that, I'm going to keep you guys updated on what I personally feel about the content. I'm going to do a review on that. I'm going to do a review on the costs associated with obtaining the certificate and a quick comparison to the CompTIA Security Plus, which is the de facto standard trusted amongst industry as a beginner cybersecurity certification. I would consider Google certificate to be a competitor to that, although it's not as trusted as much as, again, is relatively new. We need more time with it to see what kind of workforce it produces, what kind of education and any experience, and how it's received in the industry. So we're still standing by for that. But I'm going to go over a basic review based off of the cost, the content, and my recommendations on how I feel whether it's worth it or not. The first thing I want to talk about is the cost of the certification. So they are providing it through the Coursera platform. Coursera is an education platform. They have various topics of online teachings, online courses. I do have a link below if you want to click on that. If you want to take a look at it for yourself, go ahead and do so. But it's through Coursera, right? So a subscription base for $49 a month. As long as you're in the program, as long as you're taking a course and you're active, it's $49 a month until you cancel. With that being said, at this moment in time, the Security Plus exam, if you go to the CompTIA website, is just for the exam, it's $392, right? That's just the exam voucher. And that's not including any coursework or any boot camps or any type of courses or classes or anything that they bundle with that you can get through CompTIA or any other avenue, any other course out there, any other boot camps, you know, that are out there. So for just the exam, Security Plus is $392. Right? So that's a one-time fee paid once. Again, granted, if you're not adding any coursework or any boot camps to that, which could be thousands of dollars. The Google certificate itself is a course, right? So again, it's a monthly subscription. You pay $49 a month. The website says it's an average completion time of 3 to 6 months. So obviously, if you can wrap the course up faster, right, you save money. In 3 months, that's about $150. If you complete it in 6 months, obviously, that's $300. And obviously, if you take longer than that, it's going to be more as you go along. As far as the cost concern, I think that's really good, right? Obviously, because if you're motivated, you can get it done quicker. You can save money, obviously. If you do it in 1 month or 2 months, you're looking at $50 to $100 right there. And this is from their timetable that they're saying it takes to complete it. Obviously, it's more. If you take longer, it could be much less if you finish it quicker. Now, as far as content, there are 8 modules or 8 sections, 8 categories, 8 courses in the cybersecurity certificate. So the first module is Foundations of Cybersecurity, which is 14 hours. You have Play It Safe, Manage Security Risks, which is 12 hours. You have Connect and Protect Networks and Network Security, which is 14 hours. Tools of the Trade, Linux and SQL, which is 26 hours. That's a healthy section there. Assets, threats, and vulnerabilities, that's 24 hours. We have sound the alarm, detection and response, 23 hours. Automate cybersecurity tasks with Python, which is I'm actually excited about that one, 28 hours. And then we have put it to work, prepare for cybersecurity jobs, 15 hours. So as you can see, as the course goes along, the amount of hours required to complete it greatens over time, right? I'm really excited about the Python course. And Linux. I have a Linux Plus certification. It's been a while since I've dove into any Linux heavy thing, so I'm excited about that one when I take it, to be honest. But if you add up all the hours for all the courses, and again, this is off the website, it equals 156 hours to complete the course. It says it takes about 6 months if you dedicate or commit 7 hours a day, right? So most of us are working, most of us have families, most of us are probably in school. If you did the math, right, to see how many hours is available to you in a 6 month time frame, right? We do 30 days times 6 equals So there's 180 days in a 6 month time frame. He times that by 24 hours to get the number of hours in 6 months. We have 4,320. Take away 2/3 of that for sleeping and working, right? At a bare minimum, you're looking at 1,468 hours of extra time to complete the course. Now, I think that's more than enough. 1,400 hours to complete a 156-hour course. 156 hours spread out over 6 months. I think that's very generous. It depends on, you know, work-life balance, school, family, et cetera, et cetera. We're all pretty busy, right? So I plan on starting this literally right after I record this video. I'm going to sign up. I'm going to start the clock, and I'm going to jump into the course. For me personally, I have CISSP. I have Security Plus. I have Linux. I have Pentest Plus. I have a bunch of other certs. If you're new to the certification industry, right? If you're looking to get into cybersecurity and you're looking at what certs you want to get or what industry you want to break into, what field, understand that once you start to acquire certifications, there is a maintenance portion of maintaining them and keeping them, right? So maybe about 10, 15 years ago, there used to be, in the industry anyway, there was you get it once, you pass the test once, and you were certified for life. A lot of that has changed. Now it's you get certified and you have to maintain it through completing continuing education, getting credit, obviously paying maintenance fees, right? So once you join these organizations, you got to pay an annual due or an annual fee to maintain it, to stay in good graces with the organization that you got certified through, and also maintain your education, right? Continue education, learn, and you got to show proof of maintaining education. It could be taking other courses. It could be doing talks, presentations. It could be a number of things, right? This is just one of the things of certification when it comes in the IT industry. Once you get certified for something, most likely, generally, they have this thing where to maintain it, you have to pay the fee and maintain your education in that field. Now, the reason I'm going to pursue this Google Cyber Certificate is because 156 hours of coursework satisfies my 3-year CISSP continuing education obligation. I got my CISSP in 2015. It's on a 3-year renewal cycle, so you pay, you know, every year your maintenance fee, and then you have 40 CEUs you have to acquire each year of the 3-year cycle, so that equals 120. Now, a really cool tip, trick that I have used in my career with certifications is to maintain my CEUs and maintain these certifications, I just take another cert, right? And the coursework and the boot camp or whatever studying I'm doing, I use as CEUs to maintain the other one. So this is perfect for me because once I take this certification, when I get proof of completion, I can submit it to ISC Squared and I can pretty much recertify for the next 3 years, right? I need 120 CEUs for CISSP. The course is 156 hours. If I complete the course, I could apply all of that to my CISSP and I'll be good to go. This is a cool tip, trick that I developed over time. Of course, there's other ways to obtain your CEUs, but I feel this has been the best for me. You can do this as well. I don't know if Google has a CEU thing to maintain this. I would imagine they do because it's an industry standard at the moment. At this time, it's not clear if this Google cert will require CEUs to maintain it. I haven't personally took it myself. So once I dive in and I learn more about it, I'll definitely keep you updated. I would imagine they are because it's just an industry standard at this point. It's going through Coursera, so maybe Coursera is different when it comes to CEUs and continuing education and whatnot. If you know this, please go ahead and comment and let me know really quick. I'd appreciate that. When it comes to certifications and trying to make yourself more attractive in resumes and in job searches, for me personally, and again, this has worked for me, whatever you can do to beef up your resume and make you more attractive works, right? So for me, combining certifications in your field with a college degree generally is the way to go. Now, I know there's different opinions on this. You know, there are some people that rely heavily on college degrees only with no certifications. And then there are people that really rely heavily on certifications and don't really weigh college degrees that much or feel it's not necessary. And again, there are stories you can pick and choose. You can find people that have found for that to work for them. But what has worked for me personally is I combined two. And I found it does help you, in the very least, get a job interview, which is probably one of the main things that you would want to do, especially if you're in the job search, is get a foot in the door in the interview at least, right? And how do you do that? Especially if you're going in and you don't know anybody, right? And you don't have a connect or an in, and you just have your resume or your job application to try to get an employer to look at you and to give you a chance. More certifications, college education. Obviously, you want to put experience up there. If you don't have experience, there are ways you can creatively find ways to gain experience and put on a resume. But again, if you think about it as a numbers game and employers looking at resumes, they're going to more than likely decide to interview somebody who has shown they are putting emphasis on certifications, college, and experience. Those are the three trifecta of what gets you through the door, at least in an interview, right? The resume is the first part. The interview is obviously the second part. And then, you go from there. I would definitely recommend this certificate for people trying to get into the field, breaking into the industry. You can get it while you're in school. You can get it after school. And again, for the price, if you have the time to dedicate, you can knock it out in a couple of months. $100, you get a Google certificate that says you know some stuff or you have some experience in cybersecurity field. 156 hours is pretty decent to put on a resume, especially if you're new in the industry. Let's say you're an employer and you have two resumes and they are equal, right? In experience, education, or whatever. But one happens to have the Google Professional certificate and the other one doesn't. Which one is more attractive, right? Which one weighs better or weighs more? That's how I view pursuing certificates, right? It's going to help. It can't hurt, right? In the very least, you'll know more, you'll learn more, but it can't hurt. That's my overall review of the Google Cybersecurity Professional Certificate. I say go for it, especially if you're new to the industry and you want to break in. If you've been in the industry and you need material to add to your CEUs, do it. And do it for review, right? Technology is always changing. Obviously, we know this. We know material changes all the time. These certification tests change all the time. I'm excited to start this certificate. I'm going to keep you guys posted on that. If you have any questions, comments, concerns, please hit the comments. And again, thank you so much for watching this video. Please go ahead and like, share, and subscribe. If you're interested in taking the course, hit the link below. Sign up for the course. Let me know what you think about it yourself. And I will see you guys soon. Thank you so much.